The Prophet says there is no harm in Islam. Scholars and maraja have examined this hadith. When the Prophet says there is no harm in Islam, they have derived qa'idat la darar. There should be no harm in Islam, meaning anything that's harmful is haram. So now let's take this hadith and see what are the applications. Now, when it comes to your physical harm on your body, there are three types of harm. One type of harm is to cut a body part, like a finger, an arm, a leg. That's haram according to the ijma' of all scholars. Because the law of no harm says you cannot do that to yourself. That's one type of harm. The second type of harm is not for you to amputate or cut a body part, but to cause damage to one of your senses. إِتْلَافُ قُوَّةٍ مِنْ قُوَى الْبَدَنِ. For example, you drink something, you eat something, you do something that makes you go blind. That's haram. Why? The law of no harm. That's the second example. The third example is putting your body through harm by drinking, eating, or smoking something that's harmful. If it's excessive harm, it's haram. If it's excessive harm, it's haram. Well, let's talk about excessive harm. What does it mean when we say excessive harm? Not all types of harm are haram. There are many things that are unhealthy to your body, but we can't say they're all haram. Chips and dip. Which one of you loves chips and dip? Is it healthy? Can I say it's haram? No. Buklawa. Is it healthy? The buklawa of the hajj is the healthiest of the healthy. But other buklawas, are they healthy? See, if you eat it moderately, right, it doesn't pose that much harm to you, it's fine. It's not haram. But if you're eating buklawa for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, right, every single day, and that will make you sick, it will, God forbid, cause diabetes or any sorts of other problems. It's haram. It's haram. If you eat unhealthy food every single day, you drink soda, you eat chips, you eat that juicy hamburger, you eat something that's unhealthy, scholars say it's haram because you're causing excessive damage to your body. That's haram. Yes, if you drink soda occasionally, you eat that hamburger occasionally, you eat buklawa occasionally, that's fine. It may do some damage, but that's fine. That amount of damage is okay to the body. It's not something that we have evidence, it's haram. Let's take this concept and put it on smoking. You have to ask the medical experts, the medical community, about smoking. Those who are addicted to smoking, they smoke a full pack of cigarettes every day. I don't think there's a doctor who will tell you that's not excessive harm. It is excessive harm, right? So some maraja say if it is excessive harm, and between you and your Lord, you believe it's excessive harm, to smoke to that extent, then it becomes haram. But let's say you smoke occasionally, right? Or the amount of smoking that you do, yes, it does have some harm, but you don't believe that it's excessive harm. Between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't think that it's excessive harm, then yes, there is no evidence for it to be haram. So I can't give you a blanket statement over here whether smoking is haram or not. It depends. It depends on your health, on your circumstances. Sometimes you may have a heart condition, you may have high blood pressure, you may be diabetic, you may be experiencing some situation. Any smoking probably would be harmful to you. Then that is to be avoided. But if you're healthy, and let's say this person is occasionally smoking, not to the point where it's excessive harm, then yes, most maraji say it is halal, it's not haram. So that's the ruling on it.